Yo, what's going on everybody? Welcome back to the channel. So as promised in the closet tour video, we now have the sneaker collection video for you guys. So judging from the title, you may think I spend a whole bunch of money on these shoes, and I have definitely, you know, spent my fair share of money on shoes, but the title is just what the total value is for the entire collection based on the current resale market. So some shoes I pay resale for, some I trade for, some things like that, but don't think I spend all that money on these shoes. So starting off the collection, we have an ASICS Gel Light 3 right here. This is the Mida collab 30th anniversary. Just a really dope, you know, shoe I came across online. Good materials, great colorway, and shout out to Mida in Japan. You have that Far East right there on the bottom. Just shouting out Japan right there. Alright, moving on to New Balance. So I have a few pairs of New Balances. This one is the Bodega No Bad Days. It had three different shoes, No Bad Days, No Days Off, and Better Days. So just as we know with New Balance, they're gonna just pay attention to the quality, different colors. This is the 99S or 997S with that little extra heel tab back there. And yeah, great shoe. If you guys can find one for a good price, go for it. All right, now onto another New Balance. We have the Aimé Leon Dior collab with New Balance on the 1300. And as you can see, the tag is still on these. I haven't worn them yet, but just from what I know from ALD and New Balance, I know this is a great shoe. I can't wait to rock it. Goes with everything. And speaking of ALD, we have probably one of the most sought after New Balances of the last year. This is the New Balance 550. So this is the first retro of the New Balance basketball model from the 80s. And this shoe has just gone up crazy in price. Just great colors, gray, neutral white, cream. Honestly, it's hard to get them now for less than 500, 600, but if they put out more colorways, I definitely recommend going after them. And you cannot talk about Adidas without talking about this shoe. The Yeezy line just reinvigorated the entire Adidas brand. I don't have that many Yeezys anymore, I don't really go for them, but just a simple triple black colorway, could wear this with anything every day, just super comfortable, need this in the collection. And this pair of Yeezys may hurt a few people. No one knew these was going to restock as many times as they did. The Zebra 350s, when they first came out, people were spending crazy bread, $3,000, $2,000, $1,500, trading in their whole collections for them. But you know, like Kanye said, everyone that wanted Yeezys was going to get them. So I was happy I got mine for retail, probably the third or fourth restock, but just probably the best 350 that's come out. And here we have probably the most hated Yeezy ever. When these first came out and pictures came out, everybody hated on this shoe. This is just a classic Yeezy. Some people say the best Adidas Yeezy ever, just from the materials, the different colors, starting off the whole chunky dad shoe wave, no pun intended. And these are actually restocking in August, so if you guys don't have a pair, definitely recommend going for a pair. Alright, moving on to Nikes, most people's favorite brands and one of the hottest shoes of the last 3 years. So Nike SB Dunks, these are the Purple Lobsters by Concepts. I got these for a steal. If you look at the prices now, these are going for over $1,000. I got mine for like $280, I think. Just great materials, great concept, no pun intended. Great shoe. Just, I have no other words to say about it. And here we have what you could say really started off the entire dunk craze. These Syracuse Dunks, along with the Kentuckys, just changed the entire landscape of the sneaker game last year. Most dunks retail for around 100. These right now are going anywhere from 500 to 600, depending on the size. The resale price has dropped down on dunks afterwards, but these in the Kentuckys, still up there, great color. I swapped out the regular laces for the fatter SB laces, so don't think these are foo-foo or anything like that. I just like the look of it a little better. Makes it, you know, a little more unique, but Syracuse Dunks, great shoe. Next up for Dunks, we have the recently released black and white Dunks. I call them the Pandas. Again, like the Syracuse, switch up the laces for the fatter SB laces. Just a simple shoe. They're not going for too much on the resale market. I recommend getting these, especially if you know you don't really have that many Dunks and you need a shoe you can just wear, you know, every day. These go with everything. Black and white, can't go wrong. More Dunks. So here we have the Spartan Green Dunk Highs. There's actually supposed to be a low top version of this coming out, which I plan on getting and then selling these. The Dunk Highs, honestly, I'm just not as much of a fan of them as I thought I would be. It's just a little too big and clunky, especially how tall they are and the ankle collar. So it's definitely a dope colorway, but I'll definitely be switching these out for the low tops. All right, last up for Dunks, we have the Samba Dunks, and these actually are a retro. The original pair came out in 2001 as part of the Co.JP pack of shoes, and I don't know why a lot of people, you know, pretty much slept on these. I think, you know, just this color, I can't really describe this blue, but it's a little shimmery. The gray, the red really pops on it, and then the white laces, this is just a great shoe. Yeah, I can't say much more about it, but definitely go after them. Resale price isn't that crazy. Samba Dunks. Next up for Nike, we have Air Force One. So this is the Amma Meneer Air Force One that came out in, I think it was 2019. They had a high top and a low top version. And if you know about Amma Meneer, the Whitaker Group, James Whitner, they have a few stores. Amma Meneer, Social Status, Prosper, and they killed this shoe. As far as materials, you got like this hairy suede on the swoosh, leather sock liner, pebbled leather, 3M hits all along the shoe, and just another slept on shoe. You know, this is pair 1639 out of 5269, so numbered a little limited, but great quality shoe. Next up for Air Forces, we have the Stussy Air Force One. So if you guys don't know, Stussy's actually the first streetwear brand to do a collab with Nike. And for them to still be putting out shoes with Nike, especially ones as good as this, is, you know, it's something to behold. Just like the Amma Meneers, you have that leather sock liner inside, just an all canvas upper, great color, goes with everything. Yeah, these came in a black colorway also, but I had to go with the fossil colorway. Now, even though he is now with Adidas, we have the Nike Fear of God Air Skylon. And this was a really slept on shoe. And right after he announced he was going to Adidas, Jerry Lorenzo, these shoes went up in value. They're around like $300 now. I had got mine for like $115 or something like that. Just good, simple shoe every day. Great colors. You know, I love gray. Could wear this with anything. And yeah, I mean, prices are probably going to keep going up. So if you want to get a pair, I would go and snag one right now. All right, next up, we have a shoe you probably wouldn't expect. But as you've seen in my collection, I don't just have hype items. I have, you know, other lesser known shoes, but this is the LeBron and John Elliott collab. This came in a few colors, black and white, pink, black, and then this colorway right here. Again, a shoe you could get for a steal. I just think they're, you know, they're a sneaker, but you could wear these with some slacks or chinos, sweatpants, anything. Very versatile. I would definitely grab a pair of these. Keeping it going with Nike, moving on to Air Maxes. Every Air Max I have is a 97. That's just my favorite silhouette. We have the Skepta collab on the 97 Ultra. And this shoe, just from the colorway, I don't even know how to describe this color. It's depending on the way the light shine in, it may look purple, it may look silver, it's gray, I can't really tell, but just a great neutral shoe. And shout out to Skepta. All right, next up, we got a shoe that I actually did a video on. So if you haven't seen that video, go check that out. We have the Undefeated 97s in the olive colorway. And just as I mentioned in the video, when these first came out, ComplexCon 2017, people were fighting, paying $1,200, $1,500, crazy amount of bread for these. And then they re-released them and no one cared. And I mean, that worked out for me. I was able to get them for retail pretty easily. But yeah, just a great shoe, olive with that little hit of orange, Undefeated 97s. Now probably everyone's favorite shoe of the year 2018. We have the Sean Weatherspoon 97 ones. We got the Air Max 1 bottom, the 97 upper, all corduroy, satin sock liner. I mean, I'm sure everyone's seen this shoe, but just, this was actually the first shoe I won on the sneakers draw. I was at work, Air Max day, entered, came back to my phone like half an hour later, and I saw I got them, and you know, I couldn't be more happy with this shoe right here. Continuing with Nike, we have the Nike Off-White Presto and the triple black colorway. We all know what Nike and Off-White did with Virgil and everything. The Presto is just one of the most comfortable shoes, even the regular version. I actually won the white pair, but I wanted the black pair, so I sold those, put a little cash on top, and was able to get this black pair. Just great shoe, could wear it every day, and yeah, Off-White Presto. Speaking of Off-White, we have my favorite Off-White shoe from the original 10 collection, the Off-White Blazer. So when these first came out, you know, it was unprecedented for me to spend a certain amount of money on shoes. These were going for like $450, $500, and I was like, are they really worth it? But after he released more and more Off-White, as you guys know, the OGs go up when new ones come out. These went up to like $1,300, $1,500. So I didn't spend that, but I definitely had to pay more than what I wanted to. But just a great shoe, could wear it every day. Got that little bit of hype on it, but you can definitely rock these anywhere with anything. All right, next up we have my Travis Scott collection. So if you guys don't know, Travis is my favorite artist at the moment. And I have to grab every shoe he releases for the most part. These are the Air Jordan 6 Travis Scott's. Just a great materials used on these, great suede. The little like distressing on the tongue they did, the stash pouch on the side, Nike Air on the back, just that olive green glow in the dark with the infrared hits, just masterful. Now these, Travis Scott 4's, first shoe that Travis dropped with Jordan Brand. I've waited collectively probably 2-3 days for these. In the middle of the summer, Ramadan, wife about to go into labor a week after this.
This is a sick Negro!
These were crazy. There was a new store opening out in Newark. I was going back and forth between there and going in and out of line. Then on release day, you know how it gets. It was a fight. They ended up canceling the release. Stayed out there around nighttime, around 8 o'clock. Security came around, gave out tickets. They said, hey, you got a guaranteed pair if you come back tomorrow. But I had work the next day, so texted my supervisor. I said, hey, I have a personal matter. I put in an hour of personal time. I went out, got my shoe, switched out the black laces for red wax laces just to give it more pop. And yeah, I don't think I could ever sell this shoe. Great shoe. Next we have probably everyone's sneaker of the year, 2019, the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1. We've probably seen this video we've seen this shoe a million times, but just that giant reverse swoosh, brown suede, stash pocket up here, pink laces, that 3M Cactus Jack right there, Cactus Jack logo on the back. Everyone started rocking brown after this shoe, I'm not gonna lie. This is a great shoe, game changer, and I'm happy to have it in the collection. And we mentioned earlier about the SB wave coming back. This man was a huge reason for that. So Travis started posting old SBs on his Instagram that he was wearing, and the prices of every SB just started going up. So it was only right that Nike blessed him with his own Nike SB. Just, this is very Travis, as the plaid on the side panel, the navy bandana print going along it, the pale pink swoosh on the medial side, these rope laces, just greatly executed Nike SB. Last up for Trav, we got, this looks a little different, but this is his Sail Air Force One. You've probably seen a few people doing this. They were dip dyeing them, and I had to do it. This is just great shoe construction wise. The gum bottom, the grills on the front, the Cactus Jack logo. And I decided to go with a Kelly Green dye, and I really like the way it came out. If you check my Instagram page, I posted the custom pair that Chase B was wearing that looks similar to these. And I think we came pretty close with this one. Last up but not least up, we have Jordan Brand. So kicking it off for Jordan Brand, we have the Infrared 6s that came out in 2019, I believe. This was a shoe that in high school, when they came out in 2010, one of my classmates was telling me about them. They had these and then the white Infrareds as well. Obviously, I didn't have money for them, and I wasn't really into Jordans like that to even ask my parents to give me the bread for it, but just great classic shoe. We know MJ won his first championship in these, and you know, just classic. There's nothing else you can say, just classic OG Jordan. Speaking of classic Jordans, you have the Bred 4s, shoes that Mike hit the last shot in 89, the Nike Air on the back. And honestly, I've been spoiled when it comes to these OG Jordans, because the Nike Air renditions have been coming out a lot recently, but the Bred 4, just 4s have slowly but surely become probably my favorite Jordan model, just to wear practically 4s and 1s, but I think 4s give you a little more, you know, shape and different ways to dress them up. But yeah, just another classic Jordan shoe. And my other pair of 4s we have right here, the Topes just released. I actually switched out, as you saw with the Travis Scott's, where I said I switched out the black laces for the red laces. These are those black laces from the Travis Scott's. They're wax laces, so they're a little thinner and flatter. A lot of the wax is worn off at this point, but just a great neutral color shoe. I know everyone was saying these were like the poor man's Travis Scott's, but I mean, those PEs are those exclusive friends and family shoes we'll never get. So this is the next best thing. I recommend getting these before the prices really go up later this year. Now moving on to Jordan 3s. So I only have a couple pairs of Jordan 3s, but this is the recently released Cool Gray 3. When I first saw this shoe, it was a couple years ago, I seen Quavo wearing them, and I had no idea what they were. And I looked it up, I think they came out in like 2007. And that's a little too old for me to go back and buy. I don't know if they're gonna hold up, but I was happy these re-release in retro in 2021. It's a great neutral shoe, goes with everything. It has those little hits of red and orange on them, and I'm happy to have this in the collection. Now, people debate what's the best Jordan 3. It's either these or the white cements. And I don't know, I think it goes either way, but the black cement 3 is just as classic as Jordan gets. If you guys don't know, this is the shoe that kept Mike from going to Adidas. Once he saw that elephant print on these, he decided to stay, and the rest is history. This is a great shoe. Anytime it comes out of retros, you've got to get a pair or even 3. All right, now moving on to everyone's favorite Air Jordan model at the moment, the Air Jordan 1 Classic. We have the clay green right here that came out in the Best Hands in the Game pack, along with the Track Reds, Blue Moons, Yellow Ochres. This one represents MJ going to the Hall of Fame, and the other sneakers represented his 6 MVPs, his 5 regular season MVPs, and Championship. So just a really good shoe. Green's my favorite color, good suede, and that black toe color blocking, you can't go wrong with it. And as mentioned earlier with the clay greens, this is another shoe in the pack. This is the yellow ochres, and this represents his five MVPs, Jordan's five regular season MVPs. This was actually a Europe exclusive, so I was happy I grabbed these before the prices went too crazy on them, because they weren't released in the States. But this mustard yellow suede on these, just a shoe you don't see every day. I mean, if you have the bread to spend on it, I recommend getting these. They just really stand out. Great part of the collection to have. All right, next for Jordan 1s. As you guys can tell, I have a lot of Jordan 1s. We have the Nigel Sylvester Jordan 1s from 2018, I believe. So if you guys don't know, Nigel Sylvester is a BMX rider. And this shoe just is very true to him. The discoloring, the natural scuff marks on them. No shoe looks the same. And actually, funny story, at Dwayne Wade's last game against the Nets, I seen Nigel there and I was like, "Oh, Nigel, what's up, man? I like your shoes, da da da." He was like, "What's up?" And then he looked down and I was wearing the Yeezy 750s, and he was like, he just gave me like kind of like a stank look. It was just, it was kind of awkward, but great shoe. I rock these all the time. And yeah, definitely great shoe. Next up for Jordan 1s, we got the All-Star Jordan 1 from 2017, if I'm not mistaken. So these came out in 2017 along with a Jordan 6. They call them the Chameleons or the All-Stars, just based on the color. Just a good shoe. Like, I got them, they're a little beat up. I bought them used. But just the color on them, the iridescent, it goes from green to purple to gray, depending on the color of the light. And it's just a good shoe, just to throw on. Don't cost too much. Great shoe. Doesn't get more classic than the Air Jordan 1 Royals. So, quick story. This is actually my second pair of these. The first pair of these I got were fakes.
That fufu lame shit, I ain't with it.
And the only way I found out was because I was at ComplexCon wearing them, and someone with the real pair on was standing next to me, and I just kept looking down at his shoe and looking back at mine. I said, that blue's off. It just looked way worse next to his. But luckily, I was able to get these for not too much over retail. And, you know, just a classic Jordan everyone needs in their collection. If you have one OG pair of Jordan 1s, you got to get most of them, if not all of them. So here we have the Shadows from 2018. Not much to say. OG colorway, black and gray, goes with everything. Next, we have my favorite pair of sneakers. Like, at all. We have the Chicago Air Jordan 1 2015 pair. If you guys were looking at prices not that long ago before the Last Dance, you probably could have got a pair for maybe $500, maybe $600 max, even $700. And now these are out of here. These are $1,400, $1,500 shoe. Everybody, you know, falling in love with the nostalgia. They're just price gouging these right now. So if you didn't get a pair before, honestly, I would just say wait for a retro. And but yeah, Chicago Jordan 1, just classic, best Jordan 1. And last up, but definitely not least up, we have the Air Jordan 1 Breads from 94. So I don't know if you can tell just by looking at it, but the construction is completely different from the 2016 pair. You have like a thinner ankle collar. Just the leather is so much better. And I got these around the time the Last Dance came out, so I did have to pay a decent amount. But the guy I bought them from, he said he's not really a sneaker guy. He likes history and things like that.
What?
That he actually got these in an outlet back in the day for like $60. So if you guys don't know, when Jordans first start retroing, a lot of people didn't care for them because they're technically like the old shoe. He had new Jordans still coming out. They sat in outlets, people's basements, things like that. But then as the years went by, everybody wanted them, the 94s and the 85s. And I was born in 94, so of course I was going to get the 94 pair. But really happy I got these, great price, and classic shoe that will probably stay in my collection. Alright guys, so that does it for the sneaker collection video. Thank you for watching. Make sure you leave a like and subscribe. And leave a comment down below, which sneakers were your favorite, which ones did you not like. And you know, let me know your thoughts below. But thank you for watching, and thank you for the continued